The industry-leading Dodge TorqueArm 2 shaft-mounted gearboxes feature a premium backstop design. Backstops are critical safety devices that prevent loads from rotating in reverse. This video demonstrates the installation of the heavy-duty backstop in TorqueArm 2 gearboxes. This video is a supplement to the installation manuals 1640 and MN1695. Use all required personal protective equipment. Disable equipment using proper lockout/tagout procedures. Gather the required tools. Before beginning the installation, verify that you have the correct backstop kit for your reducer. The kit includes an inner race, outer race, key, snap ring, fasteners, and spacer if required. Before beginning work on the reducer, make sure that it is properly secured. To begin the backstop installation, locate and remove the backstop shaft cover. For belt-driven TorqueArm 2 gearboxes, the cover is directly opposite the input shaft. For motorized TorqueArm 2, also known as MTA, the cover is on the intermediate shaft. The cover and gasket will not be used and can be discarded. Next, clean the mounting surface and ensure that all gasket material has been removed. Take care to make sure that no contamination is allowed to enter the gearbox. Determine the desired direction of rotation for the output hub of the gearbox. Each side of the inner race contains an arrow that indicates the direction of rotation of the backstop when installed in the reducer. Match the arrow on the backstop inner race to the desired direction of rotation of the output hub. For double reduction, TorqueArm 2 gearboxes, ratios 9:1 and higher, the backstop shaft will rotate in the same direction as the output hub. For single reduction, TorqueArm 2 gearboxes, 5:1 ratios, and all MTA gearboxes, the backstop shaft will rotate in the opposite direction of the output hub. Next, mark the corresponding direction of rotation on the backstop side of the gearbox. This step is critical for successful operation and to avoid damaging the gearbox. Apply a thin bead of RTV sealant to the face of the gearbox, making sure to coat around each bolt hole to prevent leaks. If a spacer ring is provided in the backstop kit, the spacer must be installed on the shaft first. Install the backstop with the shipping strap holding the sprags in place. Next, insert the key into the inner race and the mating shaft keyway. A light coating of oil can aid in sliding the backstop onto the shaft until it bottoms out against the spacer ring or shaft shoulder. Do not use a hammer to force the backstop into place, as this can damage the backstop or shaft. Install the retaining ring into the groove in the shaft. Partially install the outer race onto the inner race by lightly rotating the outer race in the opposite direction of rotation, as indicated by the arrow on the backstop. A light coating of oil on the inside of the outer race may aid in installation. Once the outer race has been installed far enough to capture the sprags, remove the shipping strap and slide the outer race up to the mounting surface of the gearbox. Align the fastener holes in the outer race with the threaded holes in the gearbox, and using a star pattern, torque the fasteners to the values specified in the instruction manual. This completes the installation of TA2 backstop. Contact Application Engineering for any questions. We have put product support at your fingertips. For our online selection program, visit ptwizard.com. For our e-commerce platform, authorized customers can visit dodge.ptplace.com.